Hey, what's up everybody? This is Sam. Welcome back to the Introducing Stack View series. In this part of the series, you're going to see how you can use animation with stack views. You'll discover quite how easy it is and come up with some really slick looking animations in your app. This is what the demo will look like when you finish this part of the series. You created some buttons a long time ago saying show hide details, but they've never worked. Well, now you're finally going to wire them up. You're going to create a UIView animation that's going to animate really nicely, like the one behind me. Animating stack views is actually really quite simple. Any of the properties you see behind me, the six properties that you've used on a stack view, in fact, the only six properties on a stack view, can be animated, and it's done just inside a UIView animation block. When you create a UIView animation, if you change any of these properties in the animations block, then the stack view will automatically animate from the old value to the new value. It's brilliant! In addition to being able to animate the six properties we saw before, you can also animate the appearance and disappearance of the subviews within a UI stack view. Again, you do it using a UI view animation, really simple. And all you need to do is change the hidden property on that subview. You can have a view as a subview of a stack view that's hidden and yet still managed by that stack view. As soon as it becomes visible again, i.e. hidden is now false, it'll reappear and the stack view will relay out its views. By putting this in a UIView animation block, you can get some really cool effects. You can see behind me that the top block is setting the hidden property to true, also animating the axis at the same time. And then the bottom block does the opposite. Really simple and really powerful.
You created these two buttons, the Hide Details button and the Hide Map button, quite a while ago. But if you've ever tried tapping them, they don't actually do anything, and that's what you're going to change in this video. All animation in stack views is done in code, as you would expect, and in actual fact, it's very simple. It just hooks into the UIView animation system. You need to start out by opening the relevant view controller. That's the Pancake House view controller. Importantly, you've got outlets for the Show Details button and actually the Show Map button. And then down here, you've got two empty methods that have already been linked into the storyboard. You're actually going to create a utility function to start with. I'm going to call it Animate View to Hidden. Since it's a utility method, we've made it private. It takes a UI view. And then it takes whether or not you want it hidden. So you can say hidden is true and then it will hide it, or hidden is false and it will unhide it. The animation within stack views is automatic for its contents changing the hidden property. And that's exactly what we need to do here. So we're just going to create a UI view animation that changes the hidden property. We're going to choose here the animate with duration delay using spring dampening initial spring velocity. Makes it just look a slightly nicer animation. So animate with duration with the spring damping. Set a duration of 0.8. Delay of 0. Spring damping 0.8. Initial spring velocity of 10. Options, you don't need any. So the default constructor will provide you with nothing. This is something that's changed in Swift 2, so just be aware of that. Then you need to provide the animations block. And this here is just taking that view and changing its hidden property. And in fact, the property that you want is just the one that's been provided to the function as a parameter. And finally, you don't need a completion block. There we go, that's a utility function. And all you've done is wrap this view.hidden inside a UI view animation. It really is that simple. Now you've done that, we can implement the handle show details button pressed method. This method is going to toggle the hidden state of the details label. So first you need to check, well, what is the current state so that we can switch it. So here, if it is currently hidden, then you need to animate to being visible. And in the other branch, so it's currently visible, you need to hide it. That's using that utility method. Now you would notice here that actually I could just toggle that, but there is a reason that we've done it like this. And that's because also when you do that, you want to change the content of the button itself, the title. So if the label is currently hidden, then when we flip it, then the button needs to say, hide it. Equivalently for the other branch. It's going to copy paste. In that case, if we're going to hide the details, then we then need to be able to change the button to say show instead. And that's actually all there is to it. That animation there all works beautifully with Stack View. Let's run it up and see how it works. So now if I tap the hide details button, the details disappears, animates out nicely. It's got that slight spring bounce from that UIView animation. And then obviously the button's changed to show details. Now I tap it again, it reappears. Notice how all of the elements within the stack view are resizing to allow this details view to appear and disappear. That's really cool. Excellent.
That's it for this video tutorial. And as ever, we like to leave you with a challenge. In this video, you learn how to animate the appearance and disappearance of the detail view. But a while back, you added a button to hide the map view. Your challenge is to wire that button up in the same way, so that when you tap it, the map disappears, and you tap it again, it reappears, animated beautifully. I hope you've enjoyed this video tutorial. Thank you very much for watching, and we'll see you next time.